All right, coming up next, a UFC featherweight division fight.
You ready?
Alright, so here we go as round one gets underway. Two world-class level strikers here, and the expectation is we're going to get a kickboxing match here in round
two. Yes, we are going to get a striking match. One guy is very good at kicking, the other guy has unbelievable hands. Let's see what type of attack is going to win the battle of two great stand-up fighters.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad. He's getting lit up right now, John. Oh, nice high kicks.
Oh, he lands another hook there. He's already landed several in the round. That one might have been the cleanest of the bunch.
He turned his chin, made his chin touch his shoulder with that beautiful hook. He really got all of himself into that hook, pivoted off the right.
Oh! Couple of chins here being tested early. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is the opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land a beautiful ground and pound.
25 total strikes have landed for Max Blessed Holloway.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick. Nice body kick.
Whoa!
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Under 2 minutes to go now in our opening round. Now the hammer fist here by Holloway. Well, he works hard to get up again here, but he looks hurt. Oh, that kick is good by Holloway. Punch coming, it's blocked. Oh, man, you could hear that one from here as he continues to punish his opponent. Up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Back to his feet. Whoa! And just like that, the fight is over.
Oh! Woo! Oh, my goodness, what a fight.
Yeah, that right there is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter. Now we go inside the octagon.
Windows up, he rolls like it when he doesn't give up.
All right, coming up next, it's a featherweight matchup between Alexander the Great Volkanovski and Conor McGregor. Start of round one. I can tell how excited you are for this matchup. Seems to be a striking advantage on one side, but maybe not.
This is a big-time fight. It feels like a big moment for both of these guys' careers. Who is going to be able to implement their game plan the best in this matchup between these two big-time athletes?
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the coach.
Man, striking class is in session. Beautiful punch there.
Great job landing. What a dampening punch.
Yeah, left hook found its target. Volkanovski going with the kick to the body, but unable to find the range. Oh, that's a big connection there for McGregor, DC.
I mean, big strike landed for Ireland's favorite son, Conor McGregor.
Oh, you gotta love this. He is coming out swinging early. No surprise, the aggression on full display.
No, he said he was gonna take it to this guy. That is exactly what he's doing as we start this fight. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Oh, lands a beautiful switch kick there, champ.
I mean, just like Edson Barbosa, he switches stance and drives that kick up into the elbow. Very badly. Over and over, he's landing these big body kicks. Devastating body kick land. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming.
So just over 20 total strikes. Took down the mark for Conor McGregor. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Big knee there. Oh!
Big combination.
Big knee to the body. Oh, massive kick to the head. Just missing on the high kick there.
Punch over the top.
Oh, man, it ain't DeKemba. Oh, man, look what that one body shot did.
That shows the power and the power and the placement. It was placed perfectly, and now he's got it in front of him. He went high on that one.
Oh, and he caught the kick. What a fight so far. Why, so there is the horn at times in that previous round. I didn't think we'd get here after that head kick nearly had him out of there. All right, here we go. Round two. It is Alexander Volkanovski. Against that man, you might recognize him. He is Conor McGregor. And he switches to southpaw. All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand? Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent that's going to really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well that if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight.
Well, it's not due to a lack of effort. He continues to throw, but this is like double-A striking. This is not high level.
Yeah, you can't be missing. It takes so much energy to just throw a strike. But to be whipping like this, it only exhausts you. Because every moment you try to throw to knock his opponent out, you're just catching air. It doesn't feel good. It's also embarrassing.
So we call on the fight stats here. These are unofficial, but strong numbers. 46 total strikes landed for Conor McGregor. While the accuracy rate not great, below 40% now, 38% on the connections against Alexander the Great Volkanovski. Oh, man, how many head kicks can one man absorb before getting separated from his conscience?
One, normally. This guy has a great chance, but if he takes any more, he's going to be sleeping.
Once again, looking for that highlight reel KO with that front kick. McGregor gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Just over 2 minutes to go in round two. And he comes through with a big knee. Knee to the body. He landed a high volume of strikes here in round two. Definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the corner, and now he is taking control of this second round. Volkanovski gets touched by that kick there. Oh! Massive knee to the head. Switching stances here. So a combination of knees here. You don't see this all the time where a fighter will throw multiple knees, but if it's not broken, don't fix it.
There's no takedown threat. If there was a takedown threat, he would not be throwing so many knees. But there's no threat of getting taken down, so he is just letting those knees fly.
All right, so the strike lands, but my children's hit hard.
Yeah, at this point, early in the fight, you saw his opponent's head.
Huge strike lands there. Somehow, his opponent is...
I mean, he's still on his feet, but he's not up by much.
Unbelievable.
He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
So a big round for him there, maybe even a 10-8. There was a big knockdown in there courtesy of the kick. DC, talk us through it.
He found his spot. I mean, he knew that there was a weakness. He found the spot. He recognized an opportunity to go and chase down that head kick. He threw it, it landed, and he almost got the finish.
Third round underway. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Big kick. Real sneaky.
McGregor gets the tie clinch here. Changes his stance.
Ooh, head kick lands. He's hurt.
Oh!
He's hurt bad.
Oh!
Table inches right there, boy. Wow.
It was a good night if that landed.
Caught that kick there. Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. Well, the strike lands there, but doesn't do a ton of damage. Whoa! That's it.
He got it.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight. We take a look back at the replay, and not every day you see a fight end due to a body kick like that.
That was a massive...
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen...
Never stay. down the hill, nobody tried to stop it. So get a copy, get you killed, you'll be a trending topic. A cog up in the wheel, a sacrifice to the cult of death being built.
Caught up in the matrix, virtual digital minds. We don't memorize phone numbers or directions when we drive. We don't even have to go shopping to get our food and buy things. We only push a button, we don't even have to try.
Can't even lift an eye away from my phone. Talking to Instagram live just so I don't feel alone. Flooding my Twitter feed with my deepest feelings and thoughts. My page is public, but my sense of conversation is blocked. I validate myself through followers just to feel important. Instead of living in the moment, I'd much rather record it. Nobody knows my first name, but know my Snapchat handle. I'm just a pretender. You're trapped in social media standards.
All right, coming up next, it's a lightweight bout between Jorge Masvidal and Nate Diaz.
You ready?
So here we go with round one. Seems to be a situation in which he wants to do everything in his power to keep this fight on the feet. He'd appear to have a lot of advantages at distance. We'll see if he can get it done tonight.
Yes, he has all the advantages because we don't see many specialists anymore in the UFC. Guys can generally do everything, but this guy is a jiu-jitsu player. He wants to get the fight to the ground and start to weave his web of traps to try and find his submission. This striker needs to maintain his space. He needs to make sure he is not on the ground. Avoid it at all costs.
Man, it's almost like he's got a range finder out there. Just too easy as he connects with another good series of punches.
If you're boxing this guy and only boxing him, you will be in trouble.
Punches and bunches as usual from the Stockton, California native Nate Diaz. Looks pretty sharp here, DC.
Ooh, what a punch.
Diaz's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Oh, beautiful straight left hand. And they are exchanging leather early. Stand and cheer, ladies and gentlemen. What a fight. Coming up next, a UFC lightweight division bout.
You ready?
All right, so here we go with round one. Classic matchup of striker versus striker. These guys have both faced a lot of grapplers in the past. They like the draw tonight.
Oh, yeah, they love seeing an opponent that will not be trying to dive at their legs. They know when they get to the
top. Oh! Oh, he might be out. Oh, he goes with the punch and he lands.
Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Wow. Wow.
He got it. What a performance.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight.
Come and no weak stuff.